do, and welcome to A Bit More Yorkshire Brass. It's David Hoyle with you for yet another 2 hours or thereabouts of brass band music. Show number 204 this week in our online YouTube series got underway with the Yorkshire Imperial Band playing the music of Richard Strauss. Philip Humphreys of the Egremont Town Band had been in touch to request this one, and the title, when pronounced properly, isn't quite how it looks on paper. The title of that piece of music is Also Sprach Zarathustra, just to let you know. The first match of the week, John in Wellingborough. Hello to you. Thanks for getting in touch on the email, yorkshirebrass@gmail.com. Would you by any chance have a copy, Oily, of Kenneth Alford's March the Midi? I can't find a copy anywhere. Well, Oily's got a couple of copies of this one. So here we go. The Virtuosi Brass Band of Great Britain are playing here. John's request is indeed the Midi. March, which is underplayed in my opinion, the Midi by Kenneth Alford, the Virtuosi Brass Band of Great Britain, playing there for John in Wellingborough. Off to Leeds next to Keith and Marilyn. They have requested this overture with Torvill and Dean in mind, who recently announced that they would retire from skating together. Yes, after all these years. And this, or some of the music from this, was one of their most memorable routines, says Marilyn. Could you please play it for us in the overture slot on any coming show? This was written by Jerry Herman, and the Brick House and Rastrick Band are playing this week's overture, Mac and Mabel. Thank you. The music of Jerry Herman, played by the Brighouse and Rastrick Band for Keith and Marilyn in Leeds. The overture to Mac and Mabel. Great piece of music. Thanks both for requesting that one. Now, a lovely email from Joanna, who is in Silsden. She says, it will be our 23rd wedding anniversary on the 24th of March, and I would love for you to play a request for my lovely husband, Peter, to thank him for all the wonderful times we've had together. We're both on our second marriage, and we were married in our 40s. Now, you give me a couple of pieces of music here to play. One of them, which is a Strauss piece of music, I simply can't find a recording of other than in Vienna on a YouTube video, for example. Having said that, I do think it should be arranged for brass band, and I will pass that around to some people who might do it. Thankfully, your second request we do have, and this is the first spot, featured spot of the week on this week's programme. It's the music of Leo Delibes, and it's from Lakme. Philip Spark made this arrangement for brass band and was staying with the Brighouse and Rastrick Band. Happy anniversary to Joanna and Peter. Here we go with the Flower Duet from Lakme. What a lovely piece of music. Philip Spark's arrangement of the music of Leo Delibes, the Flower Duet from the ballet Lakme, That was for Joanna and Peter in Silsden, as we wish them a very happy 23rd wedding anniversary. The Brighouse and Rastrick Band playing there. I've got a great subject this week coming up in a little while. But before we do that, Stu's in Selby and has come up with a really interesting piece of music. I played this some time ago and really, really enjoyed it. But I've only got the one recording of it, Stu, but it's a good one. William Matthias composed this music and the Rigid Containers Group band are playing. It's called Vivat Regina, which simply means Long Live the King. Thank you. The Rigid Containers group band playing the music of William Matthias, Vivat Regina, for Stu in Selby. It's a grand piece of music, that one. Thanks, Stu, for the request. Brian is in Hereford, and another piece of music which I really like. Not often played on the programme, but a really good listen. Edrich Siebert made this arrangement for brass band. Then we're actually back to Leo Delibes, although very different style of music to what we heard in the Flower Duet. It's played here by the Flowers Band, and I love the title, Dance Angoise.
Thank you.
The Flowers Band playing Danse Angoise, the music of Leo Delibes arranged for brass band by Edric Siebert. Lovely stuff, Brian in Hereford, thank you very much for that. Now on to this week's special subject, and I've been saving this one for a while actually, but it's time to do it now. Social media plays a very big part in this, absolutely, and we're talking about news, or things which people seem to think are news in this day and age, which aren't. They're really not. And there are so many inaccuracies now. I have a little game going on with a particular news outlet where they just put things on which are absolute rhubarb, and every time they put it up, I put a reply, and then I get a message saying, "You're a top user, get your badge." You don't want to give me a badge, I don't give you a good word. I really don't. How about the polar snowstorm? 8 times in 10 hours on one day last week with a different headline, saying we were going to have a polar snowstorm. When I looked at the weather forecast, it was 7, 8, 9 degrees. No sign of snow anywhere. But 200 people had commented on this damn post. Unbelievable. A snowstorm or a snowbomb. And when it came, previously, again, everybody panicked. There was barely enough snow to put the dusting on a cake. A 650-mile wall of snow is the latest one. Just absolutely nuts. And how about this one for a news story or not? We counted the number of beans on a Heinz baked beans pizza. Have you got nothing better to do? Go out and find some proper news. A satellite is about to crash to Earth at 3:32 p.m. today after 30 years in space. Really? Does anybody believe that? Absolutely not. A ramshackle house, still for sale after 7 years. This is one up by the railway line near Dent, which has just been sold recently, actually. But this story runs every week. Well, it's been sold now, so I don't know what you're going to do. I absolutely don't know what you're going to do. And just to end this first little bit, panic as man burns crumpets. Is that really a news story? A man burns some crumpets, yet it's all over social media. We'll come back to these in a while. You can tell I'm agitated with it, can't you? It really, really winds me up. It's just stupid. The reason for it, they want us all to click on it so they can then go to people and say, look how many people look at our website. Would you like to advertise on it? And then they pay. That's modern day life. Andrea in Poulton, thank you very much for this one. I'd like to hear the Freckleton Band play this because there is a connection, says Andrea. That's absolutely no problem whatsoever. And this is a montage, as I like to call them, arranged by Stephen Duro for brass band. And it's simply titled, Cole Porter for Brass. Thank you. Call Porter for Brass, arranged by Stephen Duro and played there by the Freckleton Band. Thanks to Andrea in Poulton for that particular request. Off to the West Country now, David's in Bristol. Lovely email, David. Thank you very much indeed for all your kind words about the show. And this is a Gordon Langford piece of music, which you say is underplayed. Yeah, I agree with that. And under-recorded too, says David, because I can't find a recording. Well, I do have a recording of this by the Sellers Engineering Band, David, so we can tick the box for you with absolutely no problem whatsoever. You'll recognise all the tunes in this, absolutely no problem whatsoever. It's called Three Tenors Fantasy.
Thank you.
The Sellers Engineering Band playing Gordon Langford's arrangement, Three Tenors Fantasy. That was for David in Bristol. Thank you very much indeed, David. YorkshireBrass@gmail.com, the email address that you use to get in touch with the show. Next up, we're going to Lucy in York. Now, this piece of music scored a surprise chart hit in 1981 when it reached number two. Written by Ennio Morricone, this piece was arranged for brass band by the late great Denzel Stevens. And its title is Chi Mai. Now, you might not know it from the title. Chi Mai means whoever. But those of you who are old enough might well remember the TV series The Life and Times of David Lloyd George. Let's have a listen. Brass band Burger Music Luzern are playing here. Chi Mai, the theme from The Life and Times of David Lloyd George, 1981, the TV series. Chi Mai means whoever. Brass band Burger Music Luzern were playing that lovely theme by Ennio Morricone, which was arranged by Denzel Stevens for brass band. Next up, we're going to Steve. Steve is in Silsden. We've been to Silsden twice in the first part of this week's programme. Music by John Williams, please, if you can, Oily. I'll leave it to you to pick a theme. Right, well, I'm going for a montage because John Williams, as we all know, has written so many wonderful themes. I just thought I'd play this one. The Frodens Band are playing, and it's simply called Epic Themes.
Thank you.
The music of John Williams played by the Foden's band, that was called Epic Themes, a montage of many of the great man's tunes. Wonderful stuff, Stephen Silsden, that was for you. Now, the second part of this week's programme starts with an absolute cracking piece of music, which the Black Dyke Band are going to play for Derek and Jean in Bradford. Howard Lorimer has made this arrangement for brass band of the music of Giacomo Meyerbeer, The Coronation March. We'll be right back. Powerful and passionate, the Coronation March by Mayor Beer, Howard Lorimer's arrangement, played by the Black Dyke Band for Derek and Jean in Bradford, their followers of the Black Dyke Band. Next up, a second march of the week. This is for Richard, who lives in Bilton. William Rimmer, belter, says Richard, please. Whit Friday, it'll be here soon, won't it? Absolutely it will. And this one is one of the best Whit Friday marches of the lot. The Grindthorpe Colliery Band are playing Ravenswood.
Thank you.
William Rimmer's March Ravenswood, played by the Grimthorpe Colliery Band, for Richard, who is in Bilton. Thank you very much indeed, Richard, for getting in touch with that one. Back to this list I've made of things which appear on social media by our so-called news outlets these days. They're not news at all, they're just clickbait stories. And some of them are just, well, they beg a belief, and I'm sharing some of them with you today. Lottery winners falling out over the money. How many stories do we see about that? Money's evil in many ways. It's one of the most evil words in the English dictionary, as far as I'm concerned. A foul-mouthed parrot is on the loose. Goodness me. I guess if you get a foul-mouthed parrot, you've probably got a foul-mouthed owner. How about dogs in coats? Pictures every day of dogs wearing coats. If dogs want to wear coats, if the owners want to let the dogs wear coats, let them do it. What's wrong with it? And then, this one is a 4 out of 10 poll. In other words, 2 in 5 people. This keeps coming up all the time. And the number's always 4 out of 10. And I just think it's a poll in their office. And they put their own slant on it, their own thing, you know. 4 out of 10 people don't like going to a pub. So what? That's their choice. Unemptied bins. This is another one. Why don't you talk to the council and find out why the bins are not being emptied on certain streets? I'll tell you why they're not in my area, because the wagons are too big to go up the roads. That's for sure. Car insurance. And then up comes a link. Up comes a link. It's an affiliate link, and they get paid. They get commission off it. National so-and-so day, the last one for now. Every single day, up comes... Oh, it's National Whatever Day today. Who's inventing these things? Are you inventing them at the newspapers? Absolutely unbelievable. Next up, more music by Denzel Stevens. We heard some from him in the first half. And we've got this one for Mark in Huddersfield. The GUS Footwear Band, playing an oldie from the 1980s. Copacabana. Thank you. absolutely nothing to do whatsoever with Barry Manilow other than the title's the same of one of his songs, Copacabana, written by Denzel Stevens, played there for Mark in Huddersfield by the GUS Footwear Band. Thanks, Mark, for your request, which came in on the email yorkshirebrass@gmail.com, as did the next piece of music from Phil and Jane. Thank you very much indeed, both, for your lovely words on your email. It really is appreciated. We'd love to hear Dean Goffin's piece of music, Crusaders, if at all possible. Oh, this is wonderful. Dean Goffin's music, really, really special. But this is one of his very best. Here are the Reg Vardy Band playing Crusaders.
Thank you.
Crusaders by Dean Goffin, the Reg Vardy band playing there for Phil and Jane, who are in North Allerton. Thank you very much indeed for that one. Neil in Home Firth is a real enthusiast. He loves to go on a day rover in his local area and nothing more than to ride on one of the Steam Heritage Railways. Could I please hear Ticket to Ride? Alan Fernie's brass band arrangement would be absolutely wonderful on the programme, says Neil. Thank you very much indeed. The Delft Band playing here, and the music, of course, by Lennon and McCartney. Ticket to Ride. Ticket to Ride, Alan Fernie's arrangement, played by the Delft Band for Neil in Home Firth, who has a ticket to ride pretty much every day. He travels the length and breadth of the country on the railways and particularly loves the heritage steam railways. Thank you, Neil. Always good to hear from you. Let's go back to this list now of things which end up on social media news sites. How many times do you read stories about the royal family and they're just dishing up dirt? They're trying to provoke reaction. They're getting it from me. But I don't comment other than to say, are you stupid, really? Because you really don't think people are going to believe all this nonsense, do you? And then the next bit, the headline words, if you like. Fury, slammed, exact time. Whenever I see that, I always reply saying, I'll set my alarm. Just furious, blood boiling, benefits, tax. It's perfectly simple, really. Just pay it on time, pay your tax on time, and then you don't need to read all these stuff. Stunned, that's a word that gets used a lot. And the word that gets used the most, could. It could, but then again, it might not. And then a secret code or a secret beach. Well, it's not secret now, is it? Because you've just told everybody about it. Absolutely ridiculous. Eric in Harrogate, lovely piece of music here. Reminds you of the 1980s when brass bands were on TV. Yes, indeed. Guarnieri composed this music and Howard Snell arranged it and used it a couple of times in the entertainment contest. The Desford Colliery Band play Dança Brasileira. Howard Snell's arrangement of Dança Brasileira by Guarnieri, played by the Desford Colliery Band for Eric in Harrogate. Thanks, Eric, for that one. Ray in Keswick requested this one on the Yorkshire Brass Facebook group. If you're not a member, pop onto Facebook. Yorkshire Brass is the name of the group. And we talk about brass bands. We talk properly about brass bands. And we don't do conjecture and wind-ups. Could I please hear Fred Mortimer's arrangement of John Peel, says Ray. You certainly can. Derek Broadbent conducting the CWS Glasgow Band on this recording. Thank you. Fred Mortimer's arrangement of John Peel, the Cumbrian piece of music. Lovely, isn't it? Absolutely wonderful. The CWS Glasgow band were playing there for Ray, who lives in Keswick in Cumbria. Test piece time now. We're going to South Wales, to Helen, and you've picked a wonderful piece of music written by Dennis Wright. I've had the joy of playing this one a couple of times. It's been an area test piece as well. The Black Dyke Mills band are playing this week's test piece, Tam O'Shanter's Ride.
Thank you.
Tam O'Shanter's Ride by Dennis Wright. This week's test piece was played by the Black Dyke Mills Band for Helen in Cardiff. Just a couple more on this list of things which keep appearing on so-called news outlets on social media. Spoilers for TV shows. Leave it alone. If people haven't watched it, let them catch up in their own time. Why do you need to spoil it all the time? Just general muckraking that comes up with stories as well. And they keep appearing. Maybe up to 10 times a day, but with a different headline. We get it. Just do it once. Supermarket checkouts. Look, if you don't like the automated checkouts, then shop at a supermarket where people are employed. It's simple as that. I don't like them, particularly. I like to go and have a bit of banter with someone on a till. My final message to these people is get off your bums and find good news, because it is out there. You just don't report on it. You know, we used to get brass band concert reports in our local newspaper. None of that anymore. Absolutely none of that whatsoever. My local newspaper now is just the regurgitated version of yesterday's national newspaper. I will not buy it, and it's an absolute disgrace, really, from what it used to be. Used to go and buy a green paper 6 o'clock on a Saturday night after the football had finished an hour earlier, and all the football results were in it. They could do it then, and the technology then wasn't what it is now, so why can't you do it now? Hymn tune time. Jim in Halifax has chosen this one, and I played this only last year, this very arrangement. The music is by Thomas Rive, and the Grimthorpe Colliery Band play the hymn tune Cone. Thomas Rive's lovely hymn tune, Cone, played by the Grimthorpe Colliery Band. Jim in Halifax, thank you very much. That, as always, was the penultimate piece, the hymn tune, in our programme. And that's almost it for another week. Yes, the grand finale coming up, and Donna in Scarborough has chosen this wonderful piece of music. Thanks, everybody, for listening. I will be back next week with show number 205 in our online YouTube series. Please keep the requests coming, yorkshirebrass@gmail.com. Get them in as early as you can. We are recording the shows earlier than ever these days. Thank you very much, as I say. Donna in Scarborough has chosen this one. The Haydedge Band play us out this week with the music of Paul Lovett Cooper, Fire in the Blood. Thanks again from me, David Hoyle. Ta-ra!